People can learn from my masterclass how to find the right cover and adjust it so it can be a great remix and record it themselves. So my style as a vocalist is that I'm pretty good at the warmer, softer vocals, and I like the close mic'd sound. Something I always like to do when I'm recording a top line is firstly record the whole lead, and then after that I usually play with layering the vocals, doubling, and sometimes I add an alter void, like a formanted vocal as well, so to give it a little bit more bass. Yeah, the vocals we're recording today, they will also be available for the producers so they can build their own creation around it. I am Minga, and this is my masterclass for the FHM Producer Program. What's up, guys? This is Minga. I'm a vocalist and songwriter, and FHM asked me to do this masterclass for you. And today we are covering a hit. So I chose Ordinary People by John Legend, which is an amazing hit. It's been all around the world. And why did I choose this one? So for a few reasons. Of course, the melodies, they have been proven to be effective and people love them. So yeah, we're gonna use that. And also what's interesting that it's a male vocal, I'm female, and it's a soulful vocal, and my sound is more pop, indie, housey, so that will be a nice contrast to work into the track. What else? We're gonna see what your how easy it is actually is to record a good vocal and how to edit it so you can all do it yourself. And the amazing thing is that you can also download this vocal and create something amazing around it yourself. I would say be creative. So before we start, let's check out the original Ordinary People by John Legend. 'Cause we're ordinary people. Maybe we should take it slow. Take it slow. Oh, oh. So can you hear the dance track yet? So the good thing about this song is that it's a story, and you know, all I have to do is also tell that story. So that's what we're gonna do. So I set up this Logic file for you. I record in Logic. I prepared by finding if this song also works in a good BPM, because if you wanna make a dance track around it or a house track around it, you gotta make sure that the BPM works. And not every pop song has a tempo that you can fit into a dance track. So it's 123 beats per minute. And also a good thing to check while you are figuring out what cover you want to record is what chords are used. Because if it's a song with a lot of chords and like key changes and everything, of course you can use it, but you might want to choose something that's a little bit more simple or easy to simplify. So maybe you can bring it back to four chords, or this one even only has three chords throughout the song, except for the bridge. There are some chord changes, but if we get there, then I decided to just use the same chords and alter the melodies a bit, because by then the listener will probably be able to take it that the melody changed a little bit. So let's start. This is my project. First, I figured out the chords, and I asked my friend Robbie East to produce a little bit for me for this masterclass. I'll play it for you. Also, make sure you choose a key that works for the height of your voice. This is a male vocal and I'm female, so we have a different range. So he made this for me. It's a quick track. And I also asked him to put in piano and snap for a different section. Another section. So yeah, this is just to create a little bit of dynamics. It's obviously a super, super demo. If you guys start using the tracks, then you're gonna build a really cool, amazing track around it with amazing beats. So what do you need to pay attention to when you set up your file? Do you see this here? I love this little part. It's where you put your notes, and it's very handy to have your lyrics right there. When I'm going to record it, I'll have it on my phone because I can't look at the screen and my mic at the same time, but that's just a little tip. And then this thing I also like, the count-in. Once you start recording, turn this on and you'll find out why. All right, let's start with the verse. So I'm going to select this part. It's pretty long, I think, the first. What's the ending? Are you every day? Yeah, it will be done. This is my track where I'm going to record the vocal. I've already put it on record, so it's blinking. And here you can see the mic that I'm using. I already put on the Phantom Power, which you can do here. It's on mute now, so I'm going to go off the monitors and go on my headphones. And this is also a trick. Just take down the master quite a bit so you can have your vocals loud enough on your headphones. You want to hear yourself while you sing, right? Okay. Okay, I got lyrics right here, but I think, yeah, ordinary people. So I'm just gonna loop the first part a bit. So I'll have a few takes that I can comp later. But so here. Let's give it a go. Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase. Right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love. Seems like we argue every day. And it loops. Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase. Right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love. It seems like we argue every day. Okay, let's have a listen. If this works. Putting my mic on mute, otherwise it will feedback too much, right? And the monitor on.
Loops. Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase.
So I like it to
right in the thick of
to sound sort of okay-ish already while recording. Which means, yeah, I also use a tuner. I'm gonna put the tuner on. It's an A major. Da da. Da 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 da. Let's do this. If you hear it too much, then it means re-sing it, or don't put the tuner on so hard. That's kind of my rule. If you hear the tuner work too hard, then I'll just re-record it.
And it loops. Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon.
We're past
the infatuation phase. Right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love. It seems like we argue every day.
So, before we go into a bit of comping, this is my very short vocal chain. I like them short and sweet because, yeah, I want to focus on the singing and it's just always going to be my voice, so I can work with this short vocal chain. Here you see the. Sometimes I put on the bigger ratio, but not this time. And if you are a beginning vocalist or you're just beginning to record, I really recommend something like this CLA plugin because it's super easy to use. You have the, you can easily adjust this, and there are some presets you can use, and your vocals will instantly sound a lot better, and you will really get to know how to work with your vocal and make it sound better. And then from there, you can take it from there and start downloading more plugins and use it. And same goes for plugins for reverbs. Everyone uses the Valhalla, of course. I also have that Valhalla Delay, Valhalla Reverb. And this bit, I don't want to get into it too much, but I love having like a template. So you already put everything in and you open your template every time you start working. So it's easy, it's plug and play. And I love having my stuff plug and play. Makes it easier to get to work. So this is my vocal channel. It's where I just recorded. This is my pitch correction, my tuner. And all my vocal channels will go into this one, the bus. So I like creating a bus with a vocal chain that you can send all your lead vocals to. And for my backing vocals, I have another bus, so they go to another one. This saves you CPU power and overall just works really good. Otherwise, you'll have change all over your project. That's not for me. I like it simple and sweet. Okay, so I just recorded this. Let's see what works and what doesn't work, and maybe we can redo it or do it better. This is the first
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase. Right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love. Seems like we argue every day.
Okay, I do like this little bit.
Infatuation phase.
Phase. So I'm gonna try and incorporate that maybe at the end as well. So that would be the it seems like we argue every day. Maybe that could be a cool hook. Also, I'm gonna tighten up a little because I want it to be tight and on the beat here and there. And I'm just gonna make it more neat. So I'll do 2 or 3 takes extra. Here we go again.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase. Right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love. Seems like we argue every day.
One more. Turn on the loop. Go.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase. Right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love. It seems like we argue every day.
So what I'm noticing is that sometimes when you're into recording, I can start getting a little bit too excited, and I need more calm in the recording. So let me check it quickly.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon.
Yeah, and also I can do girl, I'm in love with you. Just keep it short and sweet because it's a bit wordy. There's a lot of lyrics and there's not a lot of time. So I think I'm choosing to do shorter endings. Let's do one more and then we'll comp it to a track.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase. Right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love. It seems like we argue every day.
Okay. Always mute this. You can hear as well.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon.
Let's get rid of this now. Need space. Also, I love this, like making the wave a little bigger so you can see it better. Okay, that was one. So if you use Logic, and I think Ableton's also incorporating this tool, the comping tool is the best. So now I just recorded a few tracks on one track, and you can just fold it in and out. So this is in, and now I got them all stacked. Turn this off.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation. Girl, I'm in love with you.
So you can check them all. They're not that different, actually.
Girl, I'm in love with you.
That one I hate. And
girl, I'm in love with you.
Yeah, so maybe the first one. Oh, this happens to me a lot.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon.
This ain't. I want it to be tighter. So I'll go to the next one.
This ain't no honeymoon.
Next one.
You. This ain't no honeymoon.
The ain't is good, but the honeymoon could be better. Let's listen to the other ones and maybe we can combine it.
This ain't no honeymoon.
No, that take. I should just throw that one away, I guess.
This ain't no honeymoon.
Okay, so I remember I like this bit. Maybe this one.
Oh. In love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase. Right in the thick of love. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase.
Okay, yeah, this is good. And I like to do the hook, and you can see that here I forgot to do it. So.
We're past the infatuation phase.
That works. Let's keep it for now. Afterwards, I can go over it again, but just have a rough.
Right in the thick of love.
Have a rough draft of what we want. What we want it to sound like.
Right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love.
Okay. Two loves? Song. Yeah, I would never do that in a song, but John Legend did it and it worked, so I'm gonna do it from now on. So it's
right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love. It seems like
so right in the thick of love. Can be sure, but maybe at times we get sick of love. Maybe it's nice to have there a little bit of flowiness, if that's how you call it.
At times we get sick of love.
That's a short times. That'd be nice.
At times we get sick of love.
This is the boring part of being a
book. At times we get sick of love.
The love is longer.
At times we get sick of love.
I like the love. I think it's the first one.
At times we get sick of love.
Love. Okay, last one. Then I'm done.
At times we get sick of love.
So I just really didn't do it longer. If I would take my sweet, sweet time, then I would do it again. Times we get sick of love. Let's see the rest.
Love, it seems like we argue every day. Love, it seems like we argue every day.
Day, that's where you heard the tuning work, right? Day. So.
Sick of love, it seems like we argue every day.
Yeah, that's a good one. Day.
Times we get sick of love, it seems like we argue every day.
It seems like it was a bit rushed, so nope. We throw that out in the trash.
Seems like we argue every day.
Ah, now you can tell that I fucked up my timing there. See? This is a little bit before the rest. It seems like we argue, so I'm a bit late on these ones, but maybe we like it like that. It seems like we argue every day. Seems like we argue.
It seems like we argue every day.
I'm just a bit short on argue. Let me just redo that bit. Seems like we argue every day. Okay. Got this.
Seems like we argue every day.
Let's do one more.
Seems like we argue every day. Seems like we argue every day.
Okay.
At times we get sick of love. Seems like we argue every day.
Hey. Okay, let's do the whole thing.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase. Right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love. Seems like we argue every day.
Okay, cool. I mean, if you're a perfectionist, and this kind of brings out the perfectionist inside me, then you can work on this a long time, but I'm just deciding to let things go now. And I can always fix things later. You can fix timing. I'll show you that as well, actually. But for now, we're leaving this. This is what we're going for. So I'll fold it in. If you hear any glitches or clicks, because of course I comp little bits together, and like little breaths could be overlapping. And later on, I would really listen to it solo and then make sure that there are no glitches or clicks or anything, because you don't want that in your vocal file. So before we go on, what you can also do is use Little Altar Boy. This is everyone's favorite plugin, I think. Mine as well. Because now it sounds like me singing kind of sweetly and pure. But what if you format it a bit? And sounds like this.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase. Right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love. Seems like you every day.
So you can really get a different sound. Even if I do, I also love this one. It's a doubler. I'll turn on the follow voices because I like them to be tight.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase. Right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love. Seems like we argue every day.
All right, let's go on to the next part. So I'm gonna record the pre-chorus now. I duplicated my channel. It's super easy. Apple, oh, you have to call it Command these days. Command D. So you just duplicate the track with all the plugins on it. Makes it easy. And her selected the pre-chorus. So let's go.
At times we get sick of love. Seems like we argue every day.
I know I misbehaved and you made your mistakes, and we both still got room left to grow. And though love sometimes hurts, I still put you first, and we'll make this thing work. But I think we should take it slow.
Seems like we argue every
day. So I go over the ones where I need more room towards the end. So it's quite fast. Let me think. Let me listen.
I misbehaved and you made your mistakes, and we both still got room left to grow.
So a groove will appear in the and do la some da 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 da. So this is something to keep in mind while you're singing it. It could work really well on the track if you do it right. Throwing this one away.
At times we get sick of love. Seems like we argue every day.
I know I misbehaved and you made your mistakes, and we both still got room left to grow. And though love sometimes hurts, I still put you first, and we'll make this thing work. But I think we should take it slow. Okay, I like this. It's challenging to get all these words right, but I think sound is coming together.
At times we get sick of love. Seems like we argue every day.
I know I misbehaved and you made your mistakes, and we both still got room left to grow. And though love sometimes hurts, I still put you first, and we'll make this thing work. But I think we should take it slow. Okay. That's good for now. We can fix or add stuff later. So this is a melody that goes da 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 da, but it's fast. So while you're singing, just be mindful of the fact that you're singing different little notes. So you will it will sound better. It will be more on pitch.
Seems like we argue every day. I know I misbehaved and you made your mistakes, and we both still got room left to grow. And though love sometimes hurts, I still put you first, and we'll make this thing work. But I think we should take it slow.
Yeah, almost. Let's do one more take. I think I know what I want to do. Another tip is to take care of your vowels, so A, I, O, U, that you don't make them so short. So for example, I'm from Holland, and here in the Netherlands, we love short vowels. So it's like, I know I misbehaved. So very haved, short. But if it's, I know I misbehaved, have like longer, thicker vowels that could really work, and you sing on those vowels. So maybe you can take care of that as well while you're recording. Let's do one more take.
At times we get sick of love, seems like we argue every day.
I know I misbehaved and you made your mistakes, and we both still got room left to grow. And though love sometimes hurts, I still put you first, and we'll make this thing work, but I think we should take it slow.
All right, I think that was a good one. Though my nose was bumping this thing, you might hear that.
Which you shouldn't. I will clean it up.
Seems like we all misbehaved, and you made your mistakes, and seems like we argue every day. I know I misbehaved and you made your mistakes, and we both still got room left to grow. And though love sometimes hurts, I still put you first, and we'll make this thing work, but I think we should take it slow.
Yeah, I think this works. I might have to replace this part because you heard the toof toof of my nose bumping up against the plop filter.
Seems like we are, I still put you first, and we'll make this thing work, but I think we should take it slow.
Alright, let's move on. And I'll try to add the hook after. So do you remember the... Take it slow, oh, 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 oh. It's a beautiful hook of John Legend, but his song is slower, so he has more time to do the oh, oh part. So I think I'm gonna find something else for it. But I'm just gonna try something. Who knows what comes out? Sorry if it's gonna suck.
Here we go. Put you first, and we'll make this thing work. But I think we should take it slow.
We're just ordinary people. We don't know which way to go. Cause we're ordinary people. Maybe we should take it slow. Take it slow. Oh, 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 oh. This time we'll take it slow. Take it slow. Oh, 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 oh. This time we'll take it slow.
Okay, let's check it on the speakers.
While I was singing this part, the beat kicked in because I asked Robbie East to put in snap and a kick. So it suddenly gave me more of a more ground, a beat. So I felt like I had to sing it differently. So I'm just going to test if that's true.
Work, but I think we should take it slow. Make this thing work, but I think we should take it slow. We're just ordinary people.
Just keep it short, yeah.
We don't know which way to go. Cause we're ordinary people. Maybe we should take it slow. Take it slow. Oh, 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 oh. This time we'll take it slow. Take it slow. Oh, 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 oh. This time we'll take it slow.
Yeah, I think it works to keep it shorter. And oh, 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 maybe that could be a cool, quirky hook. And I'm realizing that we can't really get away from the soulful sound because the chords have the sevens in it, so it makes it soulful anyway. And yeah, that's just the nature of the song. So I would really, I'm really looking forward to what you guys would make of this. Okay, let's for now take this one. And I'm gonna do some doubles so you can hear what that sounds like. So this is the backing vocals channel. I always name them so I don't get confused. We'll go back in and then I'll do it quickly and you can hear what it sounds like. So when you double your vocals, I really like to leave the lead on and really try to match everything I do there. So it's tight as as tight as possible.
We'll put you first and we'll make this thing work, but I think we should take it slow.
We're just ordinary people, we don't know which way to go. 'Cause we're ordinary people, maybe we should take it slow. Take it slow, oh, 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 oh. This time we'll take it slow. Take it slow, oh, 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 oh. This time we'll take it slow.
All right, that's one. I'm gonna pan it to the left. Already. Duplicate this channel, and I'm gonna pan this one to the right because we love symmetry. And I'll do it again. Double.
We'll put you first and we'll make this thing work, but I think we should take it slow.
We're just ordinary people, we don't know which way to go. 'Cause we're ordinary people, maybe we should take it slow. Take it slow, oh, 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 oh.
Recording stopped.
Maybe we should take it slow. Take it slow.
Okay, I'll start here. Take it. I'll pick it up from there.
Maybe we should take it slow. Take it slow, oh, 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 oh. This time we'll take it slow. Take it slow, oh, 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 oh. This time we'll take it slow.
Okay. Okay, let's check it from the beginning. And of course, I can clean up everything still after this masterclass and make it super ready for you to work on. But basically, this is the rough first part of the top line. Let's see if we need any extra additional vocals to make it even nicer. Let's listen.
Girl, I'm in love with you.
Oh, I'll take off
this.
The
ain't no honeymoon.
Alfred.
Past the infatuation phase, right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love. Seems like we argue every day. I know I misbehaved and you made your mistakes, and we both still got room left to grow. And though love sometimes hurts, I still put you first and we'll make this thing work. But I think we should take it slow. We're just ordinary people, we don't know which way to go.
Which way to go?
'Cause we're ordinary people, we should take it slow. Take it slow, oh, oh.
Slow, oh. Oh, yeah, I have to fix this part. Okay. Yeah, I think there's not a lot of room for a lot of ad-libs, and I don't feel like it really needs a lot of harmonies, but I thought maybe in the gaps here I can do some extra things. So maybe if you make the track, you don't use it in your first chorus, but maybe if you use the second time round the chorus, then it will be nice to have some extra vocals. So I'll try to add there. And here.
I misbehaved and you made your mistakes, and we both still got room left to grow.
Maybe I can double the ending, so it will be a little bit more, a little bigger. Let's do that.
We'll put you first and we'll make this thing work, but I think we should take it slow.
We're just ordinary people, we don't know which way to go. 'Cause we're ordinary people, maybe we should take it slow. Take it slow, oh, 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 oh. This time we'll take it slow. Take it slow, oh, 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 oh. This time we'll take it slow.
Okay. Yeah, you can always do like little atmospheric sounds like and make it more real. I'm just gonna try some stuff out. start from the beginning and then see what I can do.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase.
Oh.
Right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love. Seems like we argue every day. I know I misbehaved and you made your mistakes. And we both still got room left to grow. And though love sometimes hurts, I still put you first. And we'll make this thing work. But I think
we should take it slow.
We're just ordinary people.
I don't know if that was in tune, but
we still got room left to grow. And though love sometimes hurts, I still put you first. And we'll make this thing work. But I think we should take it slow. We're just ordinary people.
Okay, some extra effects. Yeah, I think this could work. So last editing tip is for aligning the harmonies. In some songs it's nice when it really is really like on top of each other, because if you double it, you might start earlier or time something more lazy. So let's go. This is the flex time function. Here you can see the button. You press it and then you can turn it on here. And monophonic is the way to go. And now you see these lines appear. And this makes it easier. Where's the beginning? Here it is. So for example, this is where this word starts. Beep. That's all right, that's okay. This one, for example, you can take to the front a little bit so it's more aligned. And you can see it alters there. So this is great for perfectionists. You can spend days and days and days on this, but I recommend you don't, because in the beginning I was also like that. I would tune everything and edit the timing like super, super tight, but at some point, it doesn't matter. There's also moments that you don't have to edit it that much, because actually it's nice to have some life in the track. So just really look at when it matters. So if, for example, if you have the beginning of a chorus and you really want it to come in at the one, then yes, edit everything straight that it all comes in at the one. But if you're somewhere in a verse that's more flowy and you like the life in it, then maybe you don't have to. So I would say, think about this and make your decisions wisely.
We're just ordinary people.
So people, that should be tight, I think. Otherwise it's beep, beep, then it doesn't work so much. So I'm not gonna do it all, but I'll show you this bit. So see, I need to take this to the front, or you could also take the lead back a little, but looking at the, yeah, you could do that as well. Depends on what you want.
People.
Now it's nice and straight. Listen.
People.
People. All the same. Love it. So yeah, you can do that with everything and just go about it. Here you can see that it's not aligned at all. So let's do that last bit. And I'll leave the rest for when I'll prepare the stems to make them downloadable for you guys.
Way to go. Way
to
go.
Go. Now it's all nice and neat. All right. So I just recorded half of the song. It usually takes me a couple of hours to record the whole song. I'll do about 4 or 5 vocal takes and then comp them into a good track. And then, of course, some songs need a lot of harmonies and doubles. And I really love doing that, by the way. So I'll just sit there and sing my heart out. And after that, I'll edit everything like I showed you. I'll edit the timing, I'll re-record stuff that I need to fix. And so if you're a vocalist and songwriter like me, it is your goal to get your songs to producers you want to work with, and then they can create this cool track around it, and then it will come to release. So the demo you send over to the producer needs to sound pretty great already, because the vocal will actually sell it. If the producer hears a smooth, great vocal, then they'll get inspired to start their own production on it. So
even though this one's not finished yet, you also heard some cracks and ticks and glitches. I'll fix all those after this. Before, so if you download the vocal, it will sound super smooth. But if you, for example, this was it, and we want to send it over, then I'll show you how to bounce it out and get it ready. So, first of all, I will leave this out for now. You select whatever you need. So that'll be this part. Looks like I'm super slow with my mouse, but it's because I have a different speed on my trackpad now. I have to get used to it. So let's say we are super happy with this track. We checked it. I like to flatten and merge because I like cleaning up my file, and I recommend you do it as well. Because a clean file is a clean head, right? So flatten and merge. You see what's happening? It just creates one track now. So there's no fallout tracks anymore. So only do this when you are super sure you got everything you need. And well, not all is lost, because if you still find something you want to fix again, you can just re-record over this again and do a new fold-out file. So I'll do that. And then it is usually important to make sure that this has a small fade-in. I'll make it a little bit bigger. Here you can select the fade tool. And there's all kinds of shortcuts for this. You can put in your preferences yourself. So if you do small fades like this, then you're pretty sure that it won't just come in like that, the vocal. And it's
bug you every day. I know I'm
it will be smoother. I mean, now in the track you won't really hear, but if the producer's working on it and he's gonna put on all kinds of compressors, and the sudden income, the sudden tick, sudden breath, it could become quite ugly. So it's good to do fade lines pretty much everywhere. So I'm not going to do it now, but yeah, like that. You can cut off anything you don't need. So if I think I don't need this first part, just get rid of it. See you later. Bye. And then you also put those fade lines in. So that's ready. Okay, then let's go to the levels. I already mixed it like quickly because I like it to sound good when I play it back to myself. But this is the panning, so you can check your backing vocals if they're panned to the right or the left, so it makes it stereo. Lead is usually mono. And yeah, I already put on a few plugins to create the sound, and this is where I work on my delays and reverbs. And let's see if the levels are all right.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase.
I think it's all right. I mean, it's also a matter of taste. Maybe you want to take down the piano a little bit.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase.
Yep. And then I have these cool toys. So I have to be honest with you. When I started professionalizing myself recording, because I knew it was very important to be independent in that, to not have to call up your friend at the studio again to record your vocal, because I want to record 5 vocals a week, so I have to be able to do it all by myself. So I contacted my friend Tony Verdalt. He's a producer as well, and he just gave me a crash course for like 2 hours. I wrote everything down and he helped me set up my template, etc. And he gave me these two plugins. So I'm not going to explain to you guys because I can't really, but he taught me this trick. So if you send over a file, you need to make it a little bit louder so it won't be softer than all the other songs the producers receive, or the labels, or the publishers.
Take it slow, we're just ordinary people.
So look at this, it says minus 10.
We don't know which way to go.
It is a stripped down demo, so there's no loud beats, so it doesn't have to be as loud as a track with beats, but we want it to be a little louder, so it's sort of a mastering we put on it.
Let's see what it does now.
I think we should take it slow. We're just ordinary people. We don't know which way to go.
I think that's good. So it compresses the sound the sound a bit. And yeah, it will just be louder. If you put it into a playlist, it won't stand out or anything. It will just fit right in. That's what we want to do. And yeah, when you're done with that, you reselect what you want to bounce. I want to bounce all this. And you go to file. You go to bounce. Project or section. You can also do Command B. So if you just want to pitch the track, I always use MP3 because it's small. You can easily upload. You can easily email it. If you want to send someone a high quality, go to PCM and select wave or anything you like, of course. And interleaved is kind of important. And you just press OK. Converting.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't no honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase.
Somehow, if you listen to a track without looking at your Logic file while it's playing, it, to me at least, it feels differently. It feels like I can look at it differently and I can see if it works better or not. So I also, even though I forget it a lot of times, recommend playing your track and not looking at your file or your computer. Just look out the window and see how it feels and how it sounds. But now, yeah. Yeah, that was it, guys. So I'm looking forward to hearing what you guys will make of it. Maybe you'll make it a chill track or a deep house track or a future house. Heavy on the bass or not, processed vocals or not. I can't wait to hear what you do. Please hit me up on Instagram at MingaOfficial if you have any questions, if you want me to check out your track. And thank you for watching.